Good morning everyone, I am Cheshta and this is June 13, 2019. In this video, I am going to discuss about the recent cricket book which has been launched. I will be discussing about the new website which has been launched by the Indian Army, the first World Food Safety Day being observed and about the French Open title. So let's begin with the first question, where the question is asking about the organization which has released the Fiscal Performance Index to assess the quality of central and state government budget. So Fiscal Performance Index, this is very important to note that some organization has released this Fiscal Performance Index to assess the both the central and the state government budget. And which organization has launched this? So the Confederation of Indian Industry, that is CII, they have launched this Fiscal Performance Index, which would include or incorporate the qualitative assessment of the revenue expenditure, the capital expenditure, the different revenues of the government, the fiscal prudence, the level of public debt. So these all would be included while assessing this fiscal performance indicator. So it was believed by CII that it is not possible to assess the fiscal performance of the budget just by looking at the fiscal deficit to GDP ratio. Therefore, they decided that they will be coming up with this index, fiscal performance index, where the index would be used to analyze basically to state both the state and the central budgets, and that too the duration has been given that to 2004-5 to 2016-17. So this is the duration for which they are going to assess the budgets. So basically it is important that just the fiscal deficit to GDP ratio is not enough to assess the fiscal, basically the budgets of central and state government. Therefore they have decided to come up with fiscal performance index. It's a quite important question with respect to the RBI examination. Now let's move on to the next one. So as you know that cricket is just not a sport in India, but it is believed to be a religion. So on this occasion, or we could say that during this World Cup time, the Cricket World Cup, the Indian Challenge book has been launched. So who is the author of this book, Cricket World Cup, the Indian Challenge book? So Ashish Ray, he has released this new book which is titled Cricket World Cup, the Indian Cricket Challenge, and it has the it is the new book where he has penned down the journey of the Indian cricket at the World Cup since the inaugural World Cup happened in 1975. Now the question arises, where is the current World Cup, that is the 2019 World Cup, going on? So you need to mention your answers in the comment section below, that what is the venue for the 2019 World Cup. I think everybody is aware of this, so do mention your answers in the comment section below. The next question for today is, who among the following has become the first South Asian woman? First South Asian women to preside over US House of Representatives. So the answer for this question is Pramila Jayapal. So Pramila Jayapal is basically, she is a Democrat from the Washington DC, and now she has become the first South Asian woman, American woman. So she is American woman to preside over the US House of Representative, and she was first elected to the Congress, the US Congress, in 2016. Now she has proudly announced that she is the first South Asian to preside over the US House of Representatives. So the name is important, nothing much to discuss in this question, but the name of the person, Pramila Jayapal, is important. Moving on to the next question. Recently, Indian Army has launched the RODRA website, RODRA, RODRA website, to create a digital data depository of the serving and the veteran personnel. So this itself gives the explanation about the purpose of this RODRA. So it's basically a digital depository, where digital data repository. So what used to happen, due to the lack of digitization and non-availability of the latest address and the contact details of the veterans, it was difficult to connect with the families. So therefore this RODRA website, which is a digital data repository, it has been created by the Indian Army so that these shortcomings could be removed. Now this RODRA stands for Retired Officers Digital Records Archive. So the A in the RODRA stands for archive. So Retired Officers Digital Records Archive, very easy, as the purpose, the name itself is stating the purpose of this website, that it's the digital record or depository for the retired officers. I hope you have subscribed to the channel as well and liked the video as well. And do not forget to share these videos with the people who are actually preparing for the examination, as it would help them. As we are covering the most important news of the month and the day wise, therefore it's important. Also, we have launched the May Spotlight also. So do visit the website to download the May Spotlight. Now the next question is, which state union territory has topped the first ever Food Safety Index 2018-19? Two things to note in this question, that the World Food Safety Day is the first time observed in 2019, and it was observed on 7 June 2019. So it becomes very important that when is the world first ever World Food Safety Day observed. Another important thing, that the Food Safety Index has been launched for 2018-19. And Chandigarh has topped this first ever Food Safety Index. And when was this Food Safety Index announced? So it was basically, when was this Food Safety Day announced? So it was announced in 2018 by the United Nations General Assembly. Now when we talk about this Food Safety Index, so it measures the performance of the states and the union territories on the five parameters of food safety. Now what are these five parameters? So the first one is basically the human resources and the institutional arrangements. Another one is the compliance. Next one is the food testing and the infrastructure. Another one is surveillance, training and capacity building. And the last one is the consumer empowerment. So these are the five parameters on which this first ever Food Safety Index was built, and Chandigarh has topped this index. So some states like Bihar, Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir and Punjab, they lagged far behind in terms of the Food Safety Index. So it's important that we should take care of this thing, that if it is not safe, it's not food. The next question is regarding the 2019 French Open title, which was the 23rd edition of the Grand Slam tennis, and it was held in France. Also, it is played on the clay courts, all in the category of singles, doubles and mixed doubles. Now, who among the following won the French Open title for men? So, Rafael Nadal has been declared or won the historic 12th title or 12th men singles title at the French Open. Now, this French Open is also known as Roland Garros title. So, a static question can come regarding this, that Roland Garros title, who won the Roland Garros title 2019? So, it was won by Rafael Nadal. Also, if we talk about the women's single title, so Ashleigh Barty of Australia, she knocked down the opponent and won the French Open title for women. Now, it's time for you to tell me in the comment section, who has been named as the world's richest musician by Forbes? And for your help, I have in fact put the picture over here. I think it's very easy to guess the name, even if the picture is little blurred. So, she has been named as the richest female singer by the Forbes magazine. So you need to mention your answers in the comment section below, that who has been named as the world's richest musician by Forbes, and what is the worth of this person. So it's $900 million. So $900 million is the worth of the world's richest female musician. If you have learned anything from the video, do not forget to subscribe and like the video as well. Also, do mention your answers in the comment section. We'll be soon coming up with the next video. Stay tuned for the same. And do not forget to press the bell icon as well, as it will be easy for you to receive the notification. Thank you so much for watching the video.